80% of your immune system is located in your digestive system. Understanding the association between food and the gut for increased immunity has become an important topic for overall health. We spoke with Brenda Watson, author of Heart of Perfect Health. We asked her about digestive balance and immunity.
We have 10 trillion cells in the human body. We have 100 trillion bacteria cells in the digestive tract, and they're controlled. The bacteria is called friendly, good bacteria, and we call it probiotics. And what they do is they control immunity, they make vitamins B and K, they help you digest your foods, they also regulate inflammation so that silent inflammation doesn't develop in the body. So we need 80% of the bacteria in our digestive tract to be the friendly good guys. And then if 20% is neutral or negative, we still stay healthy.
How do gut bacteria help with immunity?
It helps with your immunity on three levels. On level one, let's say a pathogenic organism like a virus or bacteria entered your digestive tract. Your friendly bacteria are sort of like soldiers, and they talk amongst themselves, and they would send a soldier out to grab this negative bacteria or virus and neutralize it before it had a chance to enter your bloodstream. On level two, let's say this pathogenic organism bypassed that soldier and started to go near the digestive lining because that underneath the digestive lining is the bloodstream. What would happen is those friendly bacteria would line up on that lining of the bloodstream and neutralize that pathogenic organism before it had a chance to enter your bloodstream. So on level three, let's say that organism has gotten past level one, it's gotten past level two. So that organism has now entered your bloodstream. Your friendly bacteria will produce a substance that will enter your bloodstream and neutralize that pathogenic organism before it has time to circulate through your body and create sickness. Bacteria also help you make vitamins B and K. They help you digest your foods. They help keep you from developing silent inflammation. And another thing they do is they keep you regular. The four things that you need to know before you buy a probiotic is you need to look for potency, culture count, in anywhere from a 15 to a 50 billion count. Number two, we are all born with a different footprint in our gut. So each of us need different strains, meaning different what I call L's and B's, many different lactobacillus strains and different bifido strains. Lactobacillus is the main friendly bacteria in the small intestine, and bifidobacteria is the main friendly bacteria in the colon. So we need a formula that has lots of, I call, L's and B's on the label, at least 10. And then the third thing we need to look for is a delivery system. One of the things that can kill the friendly bacteria before it gets in your small intestine is stomach acid. So if you get a probiotic that has a delayed release capsule, then you can take it any time. You don't have to worry about taking it at a specific time. And then the fourth thing to look for is look on your label and make sure your manufacturer guarantees potency until expiration of product. That is very important because these bacteria can die off over time. So you want to make sure you have potency.